Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, we're going to be doing a text reveal effect, and let's get started. To be able to do this type reveal effect, you're going to need a clip that's locked off, and you're also going to need some movement going from right to left or left to right on the clip. We've got two pieces of movement going on here. We've got the cab going from right to left, and then the gentleman crossing the crosswalk and Buckingham Palace in the background. From there, we're going to go into our titles, and ignoring all my titles, we're going to go to the standard titles, and you're going to choose plain white. Drag that down onto your timeline, and then extend it out to the duration of the clip. Double tap on the type layer, then tap on titles. And then from there, you can edit your text. Seeing as this is London, might as well call the effect London. Tap done. And then we're going to change the font from Arial MT to Helvetica New, just because I think it's a cleaner font. Next, we're going to scroll down and look at our positioning. Now, remember, center X goes left and right, the Y goes up and down, and this is what we're wanting to do, because we're wanting to bring the text down so that when we reverse the effect, we want to just have it sitting the back end of the cab, like so. Once we've got our text in position, we can come out of our adjustments. Now we just want to play it through to make sure the text is in the right position. That looks pretty good. Then all we have to do now is highlight the plain white text, press 1 on the keyboard if you're using the keyboard, if not, or tap the pencil icon. And from there, we're going to go to cropping. And the cropping is where the magic happens, because we're going to use the left crop to hide the text. And then we're just going to work our way along, frame at a time, until we get the cab in a good position, which is looking like there. Yep, just about. We'll start at the back end of the cab, and then we're going to drop a keyframe. Then what we're going to do is just move one frame at a time, so one frame using the right arrow key, and then just tapping and holding the left crop until we line up with the back of the cab. And then again, move a frame, press and hold, you'll see the type being revealed. Move a frame again every time you start to encroach upon the bumper. Now this time I'm going to go just slightly further into the back of the cab rather than stopping at the edge of the bumper. And the reason why the text reveal works is because this is 24 frames per second. It's been shot at a 48th, so there's a nice motion blur, and we're relying upon that motion blur to hide the fact that the text is not completely lined up with the back of the cab. Hope that makes sense. So again, just move along a frame, press and hold until the text lines up. And this time we haven't got any new text as yet. Again, move a frame and you'll see the text being revealed. Move a frame, and we just continue this until all of the text has been revealed. So you'll see this time we're getting a sort of straight stroke line. So this is the other part of the N. So I'm just going to stop at the edge of the bumper at the back of the cab, advance the frame again, and you'll see this time we're going to start getting the rest of the N. So I'm going to take it just to the back of the cab rather than the bumper. Press and hold. And we've got a bit of a tight reveal for the O. Since then I'm stopping at the bumper, moving forward again, and moving forward once more. Now I'm using the magic keyboard and the trackpad, so you'll probably hear more in-depth little thumps on the trackpad, and also you can see what I'm doing on the screen, which I think's a little bit easier than me using the Apple Pencil for tutorials. So again, I'm moving along one frame, and we'll probably find that is all of the text revealed. So what I do at this point is just one more frame and then just reset the left so the text has been revealed. And then we can just go back to the beginning, play the clip through, and there we go. Now, the next stage is going to be hiding the type again. And this time it's a little bit trickier because we're working with a human, so it's not quite as straight as a cab. But let me show you that now. This time we're going to be using the right crop slider because we're going to chase this guy's legs and hide the text. if we start, let's see here, that looks pretty good. And then just move one frame at a time. I'll go back to my trackpad. Make sure I'm going the right way. And this time I'm just going to use probably his knee, right about there. And then advance a frame. And this is just going to take a little bit of tapping and maybe going back a little bit just to make sure we line up. Again, advance a frame and press and hold. I'm just making sure that the text just contacts the leg and then advance a frame again. So this is a little bit more fine-tuned than working with the cab. Again, advance the frame. Let me go past, see my position, and then back ever so slightly. Advance the frame again. Start to swallow the O. And again, I'm just going to go past it and then just bring it back. It's easier to see this way. And I'm just going to work my way through. It gets a little bit more kind of awkward here because we've got a black metal iron post in the background. So I'm kind of using gentleman's knee about here more than anything else. And then again, advance a single frame. Once you get into the habit of doing this, it doesn't take long to do the whole keyframing thing. I mean, I'm slowing down for the purposes of the tutorial. But when I was actually doing this just to practice earlier on, I was able to do the whole thing pretty quickly within a couple of minutes. Now you'll see at this point, the O is still cutting through the gentleman's body, but it's a kind of case of where do we stop? And I think we're going to go around about here, just so it's the top of the leg and the knee area. Again, advance a frame, take it past the point and then bring it back. Again, I'm going to stop here. And this is where we rely upon the motion blur of the actual video clip to disguise what's going on. Again, advancing a frame. So yeah, using keyframes is a bit of a exercise in patience, but it's worth it. And also, there's other video tutorials out on YouTube that show you how to do text reveals. And it involves creating chroma key green screens, adding them in, saving the video, and then blending it back through afterwards. It just gets a bit messy. And this is probably the cleanest way of doing it. Now, I have to also admit, this is not my idea. And it's, I think, DND Productions that I saw doing this tutorial. Although I've kind of put my own twist on things. I didn't exactly copy what they were doing, I don't think. Although I didn't watch all of their video tutorials, so I'm not 100% sure. I kind of got the gist of it in the first minute or so, and then just tapped away from it. Because I don't like to be influenced by other content creators. I like to put my own spin on things if I possibly can. So, but I still got to give DND Productions, which I will link in the description, props for coming up with the idea. And maybe they weren't the original creator of it either. Whoever was, it was a good idea. It's something I'm going to use again and again, technique-wise. I think we can definitely expand upon it. Just going to go back a little bit. Again, just touching the knee and the thigh area. Just two letters to go. Won't take long. Again, I'm going to go past and then bring it back. Just so I can see where it touches. Advance a frame again. Advance a frame again. Now, I could have done a bit of a sort of time-lapse montage at this point, cranked up the music and just buzz my way through it, but I think it's better that you get to see every single keyframe being applied so you know where I'm roughly touching on the body in case you want to do this in your own videos where you're actually using a person to move the lettering. You're getting a bit of a two-for-one here in that we are revealing text and then hiding it again. Again, I'm just going to advance. This is us now hitting the last letter, the L of London. Advance again. And you'll see, even though I'm not actually removing any of the text as yet, I'm making sure I do the movement. You see it stops at the knee. Advance again. We're nearly done. Advance again. Frame at a time. And that's gone a little bit too far this time, so I'll just take it back ever so slightly. Advance again. Now he's cleared the text now. I'm just going to make sure I'm past this point and I appear to be. I'll advance one more frame and I'm just this time going to drag the slider all the way over to 100 to hide the effect. And that's our text effect been applied. So we will go back to the taxi cab, press play. There's the text revealed and there it's hidden again. And because we took the time to do it a frame at a time, and then advancing forward another frame and just moving the type along with it, the text along with it, you get as clean a reveal and a hide as you possibly would do doing it with chroma key. And that looks pretty cool. Okay, just to finish off the whole tutorial, I'm going to show you how to improve the sky. If you live in the UK, and in particular Scotland, you'll get these sort of grey, whitey, blown out skies a lot. Now, the trick to doing these skies is to not actually paste in a beautiful blue sky with fluffy clouds, because it becomes obvious that you've switched the sky out. I'll show you a way of getting a more textural grey sky that's in keeping with the overall look of the video, but is a little bit better than that almost pure white sky. So let's have a look at that now. To be able to replace the sky, we've got to create a hole for the sky. So how do I go about doing that? Well, we need a wee snapshot, so we'll do that, snapshot. And then I'm going to jump into IAMSTULITTLE Pro. And here's one I made earlier, but let's do it again. File, close, file, new, from photos, go to our snapshot, like so. Then from there, we want to go to the magic wand. Now, I know a lot of photographers and video editors use Affinity Photo for tweaking images, but I find IAMSTULITTLE Pro from Lucky Clan to be a much more effective Photoshop replacement. Even though I kind of have Photoshop as well, I'm just going to tap and select what I need. I'll zoom in a little bit, just pick up a couple of bits and pieces. Now, this doesn't need to be 100% perfect. That's looking pretty good. Then we do Shift Command I, it's the same shortcut as Photoshop, and then Command C, Command V, check our layers, and we should have a top layer which is missing a sky. Command D gets rid of the selection. That's what you've got to do. From there, go File, and then we can do a quick export as a PNG. That will retain the alpha transparency, and we can just close down IAMSTULITTLE Pro, and then from there we go to our Photos app. And then drag in our sky replacement, bump that up a layer. You'll notice that has undone or removed all our cool work we've done with the text. So the first thing we're gonna have to do is press one on the keyboard, go into the cropping and crop up from the bottom to reveal our text where possible. And then we go back, just check that everything's still working. Yeah, that looks good. And then from there, we're gonna need to go and get ourselves some clouds. I've got clouds tucked away in my folder for the text reveal in video assets, and there's our dark green clouds there. If we tap and drag that down onto the timeline, you'll see it's 5 seconds long, and there's the overall effect. Now we'll worry about the duration in a second or two. What we need to deal with first of all is the position of the clouds, because as you can see, the cropping to show off the text reveal obviously is showing up. So we press one on the keyboard and we move things up the way and maybe just scale things up a little bit. Get the sky positioned. It's looking pretty good. Do another test. Now what we're looking for here is a more textural effect than an obvious cloud replacement. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to reduce our 30 frames a second clip down to 24. This will slow the clouds down a little bit, and it should give me ever so slightly over 6 seconds, which covers the duration of this video tutorial. So do Command B, get rid of that extra bit of clip, and then you'll see there's the clouds. Now we're not finished yet. Note the tree line is still very white, and you can see the edge of the building. So we want to kind of blend between the two. So again, highlight our dark green cloud video clip, press one on the keyboard, go to blending, and then I'm going to drop the opacity down to just where it starts. The white of the trees just starts to disappear, about 30% by the looks of things. And then back out of that, and there's the cloud effect. It's subtle, but there. If I switch it off a second, you can see the difference. Almost pure white, and a more textural clouds. So there's before, there's after. And that's us got our overall effect. So we just run through the whole thing. Now one last thing, or two last things I should say, on the color front. I'm gonna go back to my titles. You'll notice I have these grad effects. Now I created these in another video tutorial a while back. If you wanna see how I made them, go hunting. I'll see if I can put a card up or a link to the video tutorial in the description or comments. So just dragging out the length of the brown grad to 5 seconds, 23 frames. Press 1 on the keyboard and then increase the size to go wider than the palace. And I'm just going to move it up a little bit just to weaken the grad. And then we're going to change the blending to either overlay or soft light. See which one works best. And there's overlay. Yeah, it's not too bad. Let's see what soft light looks like. Soft light's a little bit more subtle. So I think we'll go with soft light on this occasion. I think for the demonstration at the beginning of the video, I used overlay, but I quite like soft light here. And go back. And then we go to our building clip. You're going to have to apply this original color effect that I'm about to do to the building and then also to the layer below, because remember there's a cropping effect going on there as well. So tap on original and we're going to add a little bit of yellow, a little bit of magenta or red, I'm not sure which at the moment. I'm thinking maybe a magenta, just ever so slightly. I don't know if we need more vibrance, maybe a touch, and a tiny little bit more contrast. That's looking pretty good. What we'll do is we'll go back and then we'll go to this layer down here. So we need to highlight that layer, copy everything back to our bottom layer with the original Buckingham Palace video clip with the guy and the cab. And then from there, we don't want any movement. We just want the color and effects paste like so. And then if we play it through, there's our finished clip. If the grad is a little bit too strong for you, you can obviously go into number one, frame and fit, down to blending, and just take the opacity down a bit. Take it down to 65% or thereabouts. The taps, there we go, 65%. You still got the hint of a grad without the overpowering of it. There's the full effect. So you don't notice the clouds so much. If I switch off the grad and the dark cloud layer, you can see the difference. And then back on again. Here's the overall effect. Thanks to DND Productions for the idea. There we go. That's the finished video tutorial. Just play it through one last time. Text reveal, text hiding, and a quick sky replacement as well. Don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you've enjoyed it. If I've earned your subscription today, then feel free to subscribe and tick that bell, and that way you'll get notified when I'm doing another video tutorial, and I'll catch you on the next one. See you later.